you want to solve this with dynamics and just find the acceleration using forces, because we know there's forces of gravity and I want to know the acceleration, certainly I can do this as a dynamics problem. Now you can go in and solve the sum of the forces about each mass is equal to the acceleration of each mass and set up your linear equations and solve them as they do in your text. But I'm going to show you how to solve this as a system. Rather than say up or down is positive, we're going to say this is the forward direction of the system. And then we just say the sum of the forces on the system is equal to the mass of the system times the acceleration of the system. I define this as the positive direction of the system. This force is a negative force, and this is a positive force. I can solve for the acceleration of the system and see these two forces and say, oh, this is positive, this is negative. And this is the mass that I'm accelerating. So the difference in these two weights is the driving force that accelerates the system. But the mass that has to be accelerated is the sum. M2 minus M1 over M2 plus M1 times G. And again, we can see if they're the same, acceleration is zero. If one of them gets super huge, then the other will drop out and the acceleration becomes gravity, either in the positive direction or the negative direction. And once you find acceleration again, you can find the tension in the strain by recognizing that the tension is just one of the two forces acting on either of these masses. So pick a mass, I'll say mass 2, and say on mass 2, we've got the force of gravity plus the tension is equal to the mass 2 times acceleration 2. I've defined this as a positive direction, so this is negative, and back where we were before. And again, let's check if we're accelerating the positive direction. In this scenario, we want to go back to defining a single positive direction as being up or down or left or right. So this is a positive direction. The sum of the forces equal mass times acceleration. The two forces are gravity and tension. And then I go back and say, all right, we have got gravity and tension, but this is positive, so gravity is in a downward direction. And when we solve for mass 2, we can check, great, if there's no acceleration, they're the same. The tension is gravity. But if we're accelerating the positive direction upwards, we know it's because tension has to be greater than gravity. Now, the way most people solve these is they say, take a mass, do this for each mass, and then recognize how these tensions are related. And you can solve linear equations, it takes more time, but you get the same answer. However, if there's three masses, then you have three simultaneous equations, and you need to solve for mass 1, mass 2, and mass 3. If you have a choo-choo train with 80 little masses, then you need to solve 80 simultaneous equations. And so solving this as a system of masses, where you take the total sum of the forces on the system in some given direction and divide it by the mass of the system, may be much simpler.